प्रभुपाद अनुगत स्कंद गुरु वृंदो की जाय। ब्रह्ममाद गौरी आचार्य वृंदो की जाय। नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जाय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासति गौर भक्त वृंदो की जाय। जय श्री श्री गौर निताय की जाय। श्री श्री राधा मदन मोहन ज्यो की जय। श्री श्री कृष्ण बलराम ज्यो की जय। सर्वविघ्न विनाशन करी श्री सिंहदेव भगवान की जय। ग्रंथराज श्रीमद भागवतम की जय। समवेत भक्त वृंदो की जय। निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल। नमः विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामीनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। ओम अज्ञेन तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। वंदे अहं श्री गुरु श्रीयुत पद कमलं श्री गुरुन वैष्णवांश्च श्री रूपं सागरयातं सहगना रघुनाथं नितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगना ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च यास्वानुभावं अखिल श्रुति सारमेकं अध्यात्म दीपं मतितितीर्षतं तामन्धम् संसारीनं करणयाह पुराण गैहम् तं वैश शूनुमुपयामि गुरुं मुनीनं। नमस्ते तु वैश विशाल बुद्धे फुल्लारविन्दाय तपत्र नेत्र मरत तैल पूर्णो प्रज्वालितो ज्ञानमय प्रदीपः वैशं वशिष्ठ नप्तारं सक्त्रेह पौत्रम कलमशं पराशरदमजंगबंदी शुकोतातं तपोनिधिं वैशाय विष्णुरूपाय वैशरूपाय विष्णवे नमो वै ब्रह्मवेधाय वासिष्ठाय नमो नमः। वंदे श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्यौ नित्यानन्दौ सहोदितौ गौरदायी पुष्पवन्तौ चित्रौ षण्डौ तमोनुदौ अवतीर्णौ सकारुण्यौ परिच्छन्नौ सदीश्वरौ श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्यौ नित्यानन्दौ द्वौ भ्रातरौ भजे। नम महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरतीश नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंध जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांतो राधा कांतो नमस्तुते। तप्त कंचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वृंदावै तुलसी देव्यावै प्रियावै केशवस्य च विष्णु भक्ति प्रादिदेवी सत्त्वत्वै नमो नमः। वांछा कल्प तरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरये। नष्ट प्रायेषु अवद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती रुत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर भवति नैष्ठिकी। कुंकुरति वाचालं पंगुर्लंघयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवं श्रीचैतन्येश्वरं श्रीगुरुदिनतारिणं। इदं भागवतं नाम पुराणं ब्रह्मसंहितं उत्तमश्लोकचरितं चकार भगवान् ऋषिः निःश्रेयसाय लोकस्य धन्यं शस्त्रेण महत्। श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 5 चैप्टर 7 द चैप्टर एंटाइटल्ड द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ किंग भारता टेक्स्ट 9। सो सिंस इट इज इन प्रोज फॉर्म आई विल जस्ट रीड इट मायसेल्फ एंड देन विल गो बाय वर्ड टू वर्ड मीनिंग एंड ट्रांसलेशन पर्पस। यत्रो हवावो भगवान् नरीरद्यापि तत्रत्येनं निजो जनानं वत्सलेनो सन्निधाप्यतो इच्छारूपेण। यत्रो वेर हवावो Certainly, Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Horihi, the Lord, Adyopi, even today, Tatro Tyanam, residing in that place, Nijo Jananam, for his own devotees, Vatsalena, by his transcendental affection, Sannidhyabhyate, becomes visible, Icharupeno, according to the desire of the devotee. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada. At Pulaha Ashram, the Supreme Personality of Godhead Hari, out of His transcendental affection for His devotee, becomes visible to His devotee, satisfying His devotee's desires. Please repeat after me. At Pulaha Ashram, the Supreme Personality of Godhead Hari, out of his transcendental affection for his devotee, becomes visible to his devotee, satisfying his devotee's desires. Purport. The Lord always exists in the different transcendental forms, as stated in Brahma Samhita 5:39. Ramadi Murti Shukala Niyamena Tishtan Nana Batara Makaradava Vaneshu Kintu Krishna Shayam Shamabhavada Paramahapumangyo Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. The Lord is situated as Himself, Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and He is accompanied by His expansions like Lord Rama, Baladev, Shankarshan, Narayan, Mahavishnu, and so forth. The devotees worship all these forms according to their liking, and the Lord, out of His affection, presents Himself as Archavigraha. He sometimes presents Himself personally before the devotee out of reciprocation or affection. A devotee is always fully surrendered to the loving service of the Lord, and the Lord is visible to the devotee according to the devotee's desires. He may be present in the form of Lord Rama, Lord Krishna, Lord Narasimhadev, and so on. Such is the exchange of love between the Lord and His devotees. So, in this very sloka, the Lord's intention towards His devotees has been expressed. As the devotees are eager to serve the Lord and thus derive transcendental pleasure, in the same way the Lord is also equally eager to please His devotees. It's not only devotees are trying to please the Lord, but the Lord is also trying to please His devotees. Very, 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 very special relationship. Very special. And to do so, He has... Jai Sri Srinisinghadev Bhagavan Ki Jai, Bhakti Prabhasila Prahlad Maharaj Ki Jai, Sri Sri Gaur Nitai Ki Jai, Sri Radha Madan Mohan Ji, Lalita Vishakha Devi Ki Jai, Sri Krishna Balaram Ji, Govardhan Ji Ki Jai, Nitai Sila Prabhupada Ki Jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol. And to do so, to please the devotees, Lord has assumed so many different processes, so many different methods. And one of the prime methods is to present Himself as His Archavigraha. And this is most probably, yes, one of the five important, the prime limbs of devotional service is worshipping the devotee, Lord's deity form. And not only Lord expanded Himself in the deity form, but He has also explained how to worship the deity form. In Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th canto, chapter 27, the Lord Himself explained the different forms of deities, different and to how to worship them. And there He explains, Shailo Darumoi Lohi Lepa Lekha Chashoikiti Monomai Manimai Prakritim Ashtabhita Smritaha. There are eight
kinds of deity forms. And they are Shoilo, stone, Darumoi, wooden, Lohi, metal, that could be brass, gunmetal, gold, silver, copper, anything. And then Lepya means made of Mrinmoy or soil, clay. And then Lekhya means drawing, means picture, which is technically called Alekhya. And Shoikiti, deity made of sand or drawing on the sand, deity form on the sand. And regarding that, Jiva Goswami has commented that this particular form of Shoikiti is only made for temporary worship. That you draw the form of the deity on the sand and you worship and you then you dissolve it. You offer the Visarjan mantra and then you dissolve. You don't leave it there. And then Monomai, you assume the form of the Lord in your heart. Every devotee has some special form, preferred deity form. Somebody loves Radha Madan Mohan, somebody loves Radha Govindo, somebody loves Radha Gopinath, somebody loves Radha Raman. And they meditate upon that particular form. And they always remember, always worship, always offer their devotion, their special items within their mind to their worshipable deity form. So that's Monomai. In your mind, you form the deity and you worship with your mind. And mind is a temple. Moma Mono Mandire Bhaktivinoda Thakur Swami. Manimai. Manimai is deities made of jewels, different type of jewels. Any, it could be diamond, it could be pearl, it could be so many other gems. So these are the 8 different types of deities that could be worshipped. And amongst all of them, 2 are most prominent, is stone and metal. And of course, Manomai, worshipping Lord in the heart. That's always there. Most probably that comes the first. Because according to Gaudiya Vaishnava tradition, established by Srila Sanatana Goswami, that no matter how you worship the Lord's deity form, how opulently, how elaborately, like ISKCON deity worship is the best worship in the planet, most probably. And but you have to have worshipping in the heart. Means also you might have gone through ever worshipping, that before you worship, whatever the time, according to the time available, you worship at certain time, amount of time within your heart, and that's called what is that technically called is Manas Puja. Yes, thank you. Manas Puja. So that is mandatory. Without that, you cannot just do external. Mandatory. First, you have to do Manas Puja. It could be according to the time available. You can do whatever time, but it has to be there. It can be fast. It can be, you can go on. And some devotees who are very much like in Bhav Bhakti, they do more Manas Puja than they do elaborate Manas Puja than for physical service. Physical they go fast, they're expert, but Manas Puja they give more time. It's according to devotee's mood, but it has to be there. So Manomai is very, very important in your heart. And of course, throughout the day we meditate upon that form, and we worship in different ways through the holy name, and we worship flower and different things. Anything we get very, you know, desirable, preferable, we offer it to our the Lord of our heart. So that is the way of worshipping the Archabigraha, and that is how Archabigraha mercifully appeared. And Archabigraha is considered to be one of the incarnations. According to Jiva Goswami and Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Archabigraha is not just Archabigraha in the sense, oh, they are just standing. They are, Archabigraha is one of the incarnations, like other incarnations, Ram, Varaha, Nishingha, so and so forth. And Archabigraha does not mean that because they don't move, they don't reciprocate externally, so that means they have no function, they are no life, but this is completely wrong, completely wrong. And unless we waver, I don't think anybody has that conception, but this is just for the sake of discussion. Everybody knows who deity Prabhu is. And Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in Chaitanya Charitamrita, in two places, once in Madhval Lila and once in Anta Lila. Madhva Lila, I think, chapter 5, and Anta Lila, chapter 7, he expressed that Vigraha jena mane she hai pashando adrishya aspishya pai jamadanda. Whoever does not believe in the deity form is considered to be atheistic, and he is untouchable. By touching him, one can lose all his pieties. And even by vision, by adrishya, if somebody looks at him, also he loses his piety. All the pieties, sukritis, punyas are gone. So adrishya, aspishya, pai jamadandu, and he is, he finally gets the punishment of Lord of Jamaraj. In another places, in Anta Lila, he is explaining that Ishwarer Ishwarer dehodehi nahi kobu nahi ved dehodehi ved kobu na kobu nahi chinto deho dehi vibhed. That Ishwara deho means body and dehi means soul. We know this from Bhagavad Gita. Embodied soul is the dehi and the body itself is the deho. So we have difference between deho and dehi. But in case of the Lord, there is no difference between deho and dehi. He is the his deho and dehi is same. He doesn't leave his body, and everything that he performs through his body only, and that very body is he himself. I mean, we can't even explain. There is no just such explanation that how to that deho. So there is not to consider at all. It is just the Lord himself. There is no deho dehi ved. And one who does that, Krishna Kaviraj Goswami is saying that koile ek paramo prabhat. Whoever has that kind of intention or tendency to think like that, even in the back of the mind, even very in subconscious, immediately all your spiritual life is over. It's very dangerous. So Krishna is, and see, Lord has resembled this form not because he does not appear in the Sachidananda Vigraha. It is Sachidananda Vigraha. It is Sachidananda. And that's also in the next line, Kaviraj Goswami said, Sharup Chidananda Naheto Vibhed. That is his Swarup, his eternal form, and Chidananda. That is transcendental and there is no difference. So, but why he then appears in the form of metal or stone or gem or anything? Because we cannot relate to his Sachidananda Vigraha. We don't have ourselves Sachidananda Vigraha, body. And our consciousness is not enamored with Sachidananda as yet. So, we are not prepared. We don't have the materials. And we don't have the qualities. Even Lord comes and he does come. He is there in his Sachidananda form. But we cannot see because we don't have the vision. Because our eyes are blunt material sense. All the senses are blunt material senses. And that's why we cannot visualize or perceive or experience anything of Lord's Sachidananda or eternity knowledge and blissful manifestation. Because we don't have that element with ourselves. Once we develop that, we can see. Lord is right there in front of us, everywhere. There is not a single atom or molecule that where Lord is not present in his Sachidananda form. But since we don't have those elements ourselves, and it is there and it is covered, dormant as soul. But externally, what we have is all blunt material senses. And that's why Padma Puran reminds us and make us warn us that Atho Sri Krishna Namadi Navhaved Grajyamindrai Shevan Mukhehi Jivhado Shvayamevo Spurati Adaha. Atho Sri Krishna Namadi. Anything that is connected to the Lord, anything headed by the holy name itself, Atho Sri Krishna Nam Adi means, Adi means Lord's form, Lord's dham, Lord's prasad, Lord's devotees, everything that's belong to Lord, everything belongs to Lord anyway, but which is transcendentally connected to Lord. Atho Sri Krishna Namadi Navaved Grajyamindrai. It is not subject to our sense perception. We cannot visualize, we cannot perceive, we cannot experience anything with our blunt material senses. But how do you attain that stage? Don't you attain that stage ever? Yes, we do. That's why all these shastras are there, all these guidance and sadhu, guru, shastra, these are there. Why? Because they want to lead us to that direction. Lord is so merciful, as I mentioned in the beginning, that he is more loving and affectionate, and he is more eager to please us, that we are eager to please him. As the father, always thinking how to please my children. All day and night, he's working hard. Why? Not for himself, for his children's future, so that they have enough money for their future expansion or growth. So so has the Lord. Because everything, Prabhupada said, everything in this material world, every single conception, every single experience that we have, it's all there in the spiritual. It's all expansion of Lord's eternal and divine activities, but in reflection, and they are distorted. But everything is coming from Lord. So these very idea that parents or father, they are working hard, trying to, you know, make everything perfect, are working so hard just for their children's future. They don't think of their own future. They think of their children's future. So as the Lord, He is always thinking of us. So that's why He has made all these arrangements, that how we can understand and get back to Him as soon as possible. So how do you then, if it is not possible to experience anything, any transcendental attributes of the Lord through our blunt material senses, then how we get to know Him? How ever possibly we can do any service to Him which will be accepted by Him, which will be accepted by Him. The next line it says, jivan shevan mukhe hi jivhado swayam eva spurati adha. This jivhado, shevan mukhe jivhado, has been explained in two different ways. One is jivhado in the sense physically, gross meaning tongue, and Prabhupada always mentioned that our devotional service start, you know, begins with tongue, by chanting the holy name of the Lord and tasting prasadam, or vice versa. Otherwise, tasting prasadam first, get purified, get the taste, heart becomes purified, consciousness becomes purified, and then I develop some kind of faith, and then I start chanting, and gradually by the mercy of the holy name and the sadhus and Vaishnavas, guru, spiritual master, we gradually become more and more attached, we become serious, and finally we get to chant the pure name, holy name. So that's one aspect. And the other aspect is Jai Sri Sri Gaur Nitai Ki Jai, Sri Sri Radha Madan Mohan Jiu Ki Jai, Sri Sri Krishna Balaram Jiu Ki Jai, Sri Sri Nishingha Dev Bhagavan Ki Jai, Sri La Prabhupada Ki Jai, Nitai Gaur Pramanande Hari Hari Gaur. And the other aspect is Jiva is the occupation of living entities, vritti, eternal vritti or eternal occupation of the living entities is considered to be, or termed as jiva, means that is their eternal, that's what they do best, and that's what they would like to do, and that's what makes them happy. So when one gets situated in his eternal occupation of devotional service to the Lord, is becomes completely free from the bondage, material bondage, and eternally situated on the transcendental plane, and continue to serve the Lord forever. So when we, and that's why Srila Prabhupada, while explaining or translating the one of the very important verse in Srimad Bhagavatam, Shabai Pungshan Paro Dharma Yato Bhakti Radaksha Ji,
অহৈতুকী অপ্রতিহত ইয়াৎমা হি সুপ্রসিদ্ধি
দেয়ার হি টার্ম ইজ অ্যাজ অকুপেশন ধর্ম অ্যাজ অকুপেশন মেনি থিং প্রভুপাদ ট্রান্সলেটেড ওয়াজন্ট ইউ নো প্রেজেন্টেড ইউ নো দিস ওয়ে বিকজ ধর্ম জেনারেল মিনিং ইজ রিলিজিয়ন বাট ওয়েন ইউ সি অকুপেশন দ্যাট ইট গিভস দি ক্লিয়ার আইডিয়া হোয়াট অ্যাকচুয়ালি ধর্ম ইজ It is occupation. It is not something. That's why also Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he said that dharma is the jaiva dharma, the occupation of the living entities. So everybody has their specific occupation. But specific occupation of the living entities is serving the Lord, devotional service. And in order to explain that, to make us understand, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has explained in Jaiva Dharma that as the salt is salty, and that saltiness is the occupation or dharma of salt. In the same way, sweetness is the dharma of sugar. Liquidity is the dharma of water. Because these things is what is integral, cannot be separated. You cannot separate. It is they go together. Like the aroma of the flower, you cannot separate. The heat and fire of heat and light or fire cannot be separated. So these are the dharmas of these elements. In the same way, the dharma of the jiva is the devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna. It cannot be separated. And that's why no matter what we do, what we get, how much advancement from the material point of view, how much advancement we make in this material world, we are never happy. But once you get to devotional service, then everything is attained. Everything is done. That is the limit of soul's function. But then you continue it forever. Because there is no disliking, you like it so much, so you cannot leave it. So that is why Swayameva Spurati Adaha, whenever we take up that occupation, and through the process of that Mahaprabhu gave, through the process of Sankirtan, Yajna, when we cleanse our heart and our eternal occupation, our eternal form, our constitution form is exhibited, we get to know our swarup, our constitutional form, we get to know our eternal activities as devotional service to the Lord. And at that point, Swayameva, by on its own, automatically, spontaneously, that very form, that very action, the very function as devotees and devotees' function of as devotional service, it started revealing. We get to know who I am, Shamanda Gyan, who Lord is, Shamanda Gyan. And then we become serious and sincere to establish that relationship. So we take up the process of devotional service, that is Prayojan Gyan. Prayojan Tattva means we are endeavoring to attain the crying need of our life, or of our soul, eternal life. And then as we continue to work on that, Prayojan Tattva, when things are together, everything is fine, all the contaminations have gone, no more material desires, no more obstacles, And then we attain the stage of, I made a mistake, I'm so sorry, Obhideo Tattva. I apologize. Obhideo Tattva. After Sambandha Tattva, it comes Obhideo Tattva, which I meant, but I just, by mistake, I. Obhideo Tattva is the stage or tattva where devotees perform or, they start functioning or start working on the process to re-establish the relationship between the souls and the Lord, or division between the devotees and the Lord, worshipable Lord. So that is Obhideo, means the method. So first we know the relationship, then we, in order to establish that relationship, we take up the process, work on that through performing different limbs of devotion, bhakti anga, navada bhakti, sravanam, kirtanam, vishnu, smaranam, padashevanam, archanam, bandhanam, dasyam, shakkamatmanivedanam. Iti pungshar pita Vishnu. Kriyato bhaktischet namalakshana. Yes, bhaktischet namalakshana. Kriyato bhagavatadya odita uttamah. So these are the 9 different processes, limbs of devotional service. And as Prabhupada mentioned in various places, we can take up one process and just work on that throughout our life and attain perfection. Or somebody can do all the processes, perform all the processes, like Ambarish Maharaj mentioned, Shavai Pungshang Mano Padaravindar Vachang Shivu Vaikuntha Gunanu Varnane, like that. Mukunda Lingalaya Darshani Disho Tatsanana Suting Chakarachuta Shatkatudai Karo Harir Mandir Marjana Dishu Mukunda Lingalaya Darshani Disho Tadbhakta Gatya Sparshas Angashangamam Grhanang Chadash Grhanang Tarage Grhanang Ache Tatpada Sharoj Shaurabe Srimad Tulasya Rasanang Tadarpite Kamang Chadashi Natu Kamakam. Before that, Pado Rishikeshu Padavi Bandane Shiro Rishikeshu Pado Rishikeshu Pado Harishette Padavi Bandane Pado Harishette Pado Harishette Padanu Sharpane Shiro Rishikeshu Padavi Varnane Kaman Janatu Kama Kammaya Yatat Tamasloke Janashayaratihi. Long time I haven't recited this. So nice, it's so sweet. And actually, by Prabhupada's mercy, we are all doing all of them. All of them. And it explains that Shabai Manoha Krishna Padara Bindayar. We can engage our mind like Ambarish Maharaj, always thinking of the lotus feet of the Lord. Bachangshi Vaikuntha Gunanu Varnane, and always use our words or speech to explain, to glorify Lord and His attributes in relation to the Vaikuntha affairs. And Suting Chakarachuta Shatkatadaye, and use our ears in oral reception to hear Lord's glorification, and Karo Haresh Mandi Marjana Dishu, and use our hands to clean the temple of the Lord, and Mukunda Lingala Darshana Dishu, with our eyes we can have the darshan of their lordship, and tadbhakta gatru sparsha angashangamam, we embrace by using our we engage our skin to embrace the devotees of the Lord. That way we can engage these particular senses. Then Rhanan Chatpada Sharoj Shaurabe, and the lotus flower or flower offered to the lotus feet of the Lord, we can take that flower and take the smell, and so pleasant, so fulfilling, heart becomes very purified. Everybody can feel that just by smelling how whole existence can be purified. Everybody has this experience. And then Srimad Tulasya Rasanam Tadarpita, and the tulasi offered at the lotus feet of the Lord, we can take and put on our lip, tongue. And then Pado, even with legs you can serve the Lord. It's not that legs, you cannot, legs, Pado Rishikesho Hare Kshetre Padanu Sharpane. With our legs we can go to the temples or holy dham. And by doing so, we can serve the Lord. Padu Hare Shitti Padanu Sharpani Shiro Rishikesha Padavi Vandana. And we can bow down our head to pay our obeisances to their lordships. Sri Radha Madan Mohan, Krishna Balaram, Govindutaini Shingadev. Kaman Chodashan, then come the final, and the prime sense to engage, and that is the mind, kamam chatashi natu kama kammaya. And engage our mind in the service of the Lord, how? Dovetailing our desire with Lord's desire itself. What Lord wants, we just do that. And that we find in the Shastra, we find through the Shadu Guru, the saintly persons and the spiritual master, what Lord's desire is. Means serving him and going back to home, back to God. That's his desire. So, dovetailing our desire with his desire means we always serve him and continue to serve without any cessation, no stoppage, no gap, as Guru Maharaj was mentioning yesterday. There is no stoppage, continuously. And as we know, Srila Prabhupada always mentioned that how we can serve 24 hours a day. We serve the Lord through our eating, honoring prasadam. We can serve the Lord through our while talking, by glorifying him. We can serve the Lord through socializing, preaching. We can serve the Lord engaging all our senses, weaving garlands, or cooking for the Lord, dressing the Lord, or cleaning the temple. And not only these things are easily understandable, we can serve the Lord even without sleeping, which is considered to be tamagun. But we can still serve, engage that in Lord's service. Means we can prepare ourselves for the next service. And if we are fortunate enough, and which happens to every devotees, because we are engaged in the service of the Lord all the day, associating with the devotees, what we dream is devotional service, association of the devotees. And that is transcendental, that cannot be called tamagun. If you are dreaming these deities and temples and devotional service and devotees, how can that be maya? So that is also. And I think many devotees have experience, because sometimes they are very intense, because they are very busy during the day, and they intensely trying to finish their rounds before going to bed, and that momentum remains in the consciousness. And during sleep, they chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. It happens. If you have the experience that if somebody chants before just going to the bed, that, I have so many rounds left, and he's trying, pushing it, and then go to bed, finally finishes his relief, and they go to bed. And that momentum is there. Sometimes we chant. So that's also. So Prabhupada, how he made us every single action and every single moment spiritual. And this is what actually Krishna consciousness. And that's why Prabhupada very nicely used that word Krishnaized. Means our whole existence has to be enamored with the spirit of Krishna consciousness. that even our subconscious, in our subconsciousness, that mood should remain. Even when we go to sleep, we cannot be influenced by Maya. Tamogun cannot, the mode of ignorance cannot, you know, overpower us. So this is very scientific. It's nothing sentimental, nothing emotional, so-called emotion. No, it's very scientific. Because we are doing these things, in our subconsciousness is also there. So we all, you know, that comes out from time to time. And this way what happens, that is what Krishna wanted. Like this morning we recited, Tasmat Sarveshu Kaleshu Ma Manusmaro Yudhacha Mayarpito Mano Buddhir Mame Vaishishya Shasha. That is what Krishna consciousness is. That's the, and Krishna very mercifully, this, the sloka prior to that, he said that how to leave the body, Antakalecha Mame Vaishmaran Mukta Kalevada. And then he's saying how to do that. And it's not difficult because it's scientific. It has meaning, even from the materialistic point of view. In spiritual realm, you don't need any logic. You don't need any rules. But still, Krishna, for our understanding, as he resembles as, according to our vision, as stone or metal, though he is not metal, though he is not stone, he is Sachidananda Vigraha, because we cannot see, he is presenting himself that way out of his mercy, causeless mercy. In the same way, Krishna does not, he doesn't need to have any kind of rules, any kind of logic, any kind of formula, no. He is Lord. He creates by his divine will. He maintains by his divine will. He dissolves by his divine will. But he does so, he presents all these rules and regulations and logic for our, because we are very conditioned. We cannot accept anything without logic, without rules, without formula, without certain kind of, you know, things that we can relate to. Because we are conditioned and we are limited. So Lord is very merciful. Okay, I'll give you according to your way. So, when we are engaged 24 hours, Krishnaized, it's not very difficult to become Krishna conscious. And that is what Mayarpito Manovid Buddhi. That you offer your mind and intelligence. And when his mind and intelligence are offered, what is left? The skin has no function. These eyes have no function. His nose, ears, leg, hands. Because once I leave the body, this will remain here like, you know, like wood, stone or anything. It has no function. This is completely useless without my presence in the body. Isn't it? But mono and buddhi, the shukshma deho, that remains. That goes from one body to another body. That takes the soul from one body to another body. So when we offer mono and buddhi, mind and intelligence, and Krishna is right there within our mind and with our intelligence, he is right there like integral as our nature, eternal nature as the devotees. So then Krishna doesn't live, and then in that consciousness, when where I leave body, who lives with me? My shukshma deho, mono buddhi. And through that I go out of the body, and then I leave the shukshma body also behind. Goodbye. I am going to my Prabhu. I am going to serve him eternally. So that is how it works. Very scientific, very logical. And very easy to understand. So I must stop it here. And that is what Bharat Maharaj was doing, and it is explained in this very sloka. And Prabhupada has very nicely explained about Vachavigraha concept and aspect. And that's how we take the advantage of worshipping Archon Marga. And that's why Prabhupada has given so much stress on it, because that very sloka I was reciting from 11th canto, that eight types of deities are there. In the purport, Srila Prabhupada says, and he quoted Jiva Goswami, I think, that without the function of Archa Vigraha, the devotional life is useless. You cannot function in devotional life. And even in the Rag Marga, actually I don't have time, then I would have given so many instances. And one another thing I wanted to say, but I forgot because of all this in a different explanation. If deities are, I'll just say in a couple of sentences, if deities are not Sachidananda, then how can he steal kheer for his devotee and hide it behind his cloth? Isn't it? If he is not active, then who is stealing? Who is stealing? If he is not active and he is not functioning, how he is walking all the way from South India to Vrindavan to South India to witness? Not many years ago, during 80s, I was in Vrindavan at that time. I heard the story. I came back home. Around 10 o'clock in the evening, one little boy in front of Banke Bihari temple, there are many sweets shops in front of Banke Bihari temple. Around 10 o'clock he came and he was asking me sweet meat from the shopkeeper. Can you give me some sweet meat? I'm very hungry. He said, and he was saying, Lala, I have to have some price. You have to pay me. I can't just give you. They address the small boys, their Lala. So I'm very hungry. Please give me something. My mother has gone somewhere and I'm very hungry. I don't have, I need something. Please give me some meat, sweet meat. Then, he was reluctant, the shopkeeper. So then he said, okay, you take my bangles, you keep it, golden bangle, you keep it. Morning, I'll bring my mother, she will pay you and take the bangle back. How is that? And he said, okay, but make sure you come, and I don't want to be, blamed for anything. So, next morning when Pujari went in the temple, he saw the bangles from Banke Bihari's hand, it was missing. And he relayed that message, and everybody was in that it got stolen last night, the Lord's ornament. And when it came to shopkeeper's notice or knowledge that everybody was talking about that, he came forward. That this is the bangle. Last night, one lot small kid, about like 5-6 years old, he came and he said he was very hungry. He left the bangle with me and said in the morning he'll bring his mother and pay the price of the sweet and take the bangle back. Who was that little boy? Banke Bihari. That's why it is very nicely Srila Krishna Kaviraj Goswami has said, Adhapiyo Sheilila Kare Gauro Rai. It's not that Krishna has gone back to the spiritual world, Krishna Shadham Upagati, or Mahaprabhu has gone back with his associate to his eternal abode and Leela is not going on. No. They can be there, they can be here, and Leela can go on simultaneously everywhere. So that is how the Archa Vigraha functions, and that's how we are so fortunate. And that's how we get to serve their lordship, even in this material world. Thank you very much. I'll stop it here. And if there is any, no time is not left much, take one or two questions if it is there.